we are not equal at all. And don't ever make the mistake of thinking that we are created equal. We are not. Hey, what's going on, guys? I wanted to make this video for you today about balance in your life. I think there's some things that need to be said if you're going to watch this channel and you're going to follow along with me on some of the ideas that I share with you, because a lot of what I share on this channel is ideas about shifting the mind, about getting you to think differently about things, because once the mind changes, the rest follows. I mean, that's just how life works. And you can bang your head against the wall all day long doing logistical stuff and all the technical parts to life and stuff, but if you don't have that 80% mentality that is going to get you into the successful mindset to achieve whatever it is that you actually want, you're not going to get there. But what I think does need to be talked about on here is the fact that you need to have a balance for your life. Without a balance, you're going to be unstable in everything you do. So I figured I would shoot this video outside in one of the areas where I actually come out and meditate sometimes. I'll show you this little brook or stream shortly, and I hope that you can hear me because the water is like babbling behind us. But I come out here every so often, and I'll walk along, you know, this area. I'll bring the dog with me and stuff sometimes, and I'll just really think about life, or, you know, I'll sit on a rock and I'll meditate, or I'll, you know, put my feet in the water and just enjoy nature out here. And during the summers, it's a really nice area to come out and just be in the warmth and just get away from everything. So figured I'd share that with you in terms of this balance video. So the reason for this video is because of a conversation I had with a friend of mine yesterday who is trying extremely, extremely hard to hit her goals. And she's got drive unlike what I have seen in a long time in somebody who is her age. She's a little bit younger, but she's got really, really big dreams, big ideas, and she's overcome a lot in her life as it already stands. Now, the conversation that we had was because from a third person's perspective into her life, we were just discussing some of the things that goes on. You know, my perspective is that she's pushing herself way too hard and she doesn't have balance, and there's a bug on the camera. Come here, you. Come here. Come on. Get out of here. All right. Anyways, it's funny. He's chilling on the top right now, so he's gonna be my little filmographer. What are they called? The filmer, I guess. Anyways, I look into her life and I don't personally see balance, because she works two full-time jobs. She's at work 12 to 15 hours a day. She's single. She doesn't have any kids. She lives on her own. She's completely, utterly self-sufficient. Everything she's got in her life, she got on her own. And the bug is climbing back down. All right, get out of here. You gotta go. I love you. You gotta go. Goodbye. Okay. Anyways, so what I'm seeing, though, is that she's crashing every day. What I mean by that is she gets out of work, she's exhausted. She doesn't do things for fun, not really. Maybe once a week she'll do something for fun. She's getting headaches, migraines. She's not eating throughout the day because she's so driven. She says, forget food, I'm going to make my dreams come true. I'm going to make this happen. And she's got this idea and this desire to move halfway across America. And she wants to hit this goal in, I think, 2.5, maybe 3 months from now. I don't know how much money she's got saved up. I don't know any of that kind of stuff. But I know what I'm seeing. And what I'm seeing is somebody who's doing exactly what I did, which is go full steam ahead, full warrior mode, and not take the time to be a lover, to be a magician, or to be a king. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with that. There's a great book out there. You look it up. You can just Google, if you just type in like King, Warrior, Magician, Lover, you'll come across this book. And it basically gets into the archetypes of the male personality, the masculine personality. Well, it's very similar if you were to look at it from a female standpoint. You know, you look at it as a queen as opposed to a king, right? Well, the thing is that what she is stuck in is called warrior mode. A king is what comes from having a balance among the other ends of your life, and then you are able to rule over your kingdom or your empire or whatever it is that you're building. The warrior, which I'm going to focus on the warrior, the lover, the magician is one that can be looked up, but I'm just going to focus on the other two for now. The warrior is the one who goes out into life and battles everything, goes out with its sword and just hacks away at whatever it is that this person wants in life. They're going to overcome any obstacle, they're going to beat any challenge, and they're going to hack away with the sword. The problem being is that when you're hacking away with the sword constantly, is that eventually that sword will dull. Now, what she got confused about is she said, on your channel, you talk all about success, you talk about whatever it takes, you talk about, you know, achieving whatever you want, regardless of the obstacles, regardless of the circumstances, find a way. Yes, I do talk about that. But success is different for everybody. And you have to have your own clear-cut definition of what success is and what it is that you actually want to obtain. Because my success is your failure. And your success is my failure. So, my version of success, if I were to over-encompass everybody on this planet, would be to feel completely content within yourself, even though you're still striving for better in some areas of your life or many areas. You have a firm understanding of who you are and where you stand in the world. You're open to change, but you still guard the gates of your mind. And you have a overall well-being and a balance in all the areas of your life. Now, the problem with just being a warrior and just going out and fighting for many, many years, like I said, the sword gets dull, but what will happen is there will be a physical breakdown and a mental breakdown. And as much as I'm all about success, I'm also all about balance, which is why I come out to areas like this and why I actually meditate, or why I make sure to balance out all the difficult work that I'm doing with times with friends and loved ones. Because what is to be enjoyed if you are to gain the whole world, but look around yourself at some point when you're at the top and realize that you have nothing at all? What I mean by this is that there was a time in my life where I didn't have the world, but I had a little slice of it. I had my house, I had 5 vehicles, I had my business, I had money, I had, you know, my girl, I used to send her off for like $300 haircuts, like, you know, here, babe, go do whatever. And, you know, you would think I was at the top of the world, but I wasn't. I was completely unbalanced. I was all about the warrior, I was all about hacking away, I wasn't about the lover, you know, I wasn't about... And the lover is not, if you look into the book, the lover is not simply loving a woman, you know, the opposite energy, or a man, whatever you're into. The lover is about appreciation for things and a joy that comes to you when you walk out into the world and you see the sunrise or the warmth of the summer or even the cold of the winter. It's whatever you like. The lover is really a deep appreciation and fulfillment that takes place when you're able to really be in the moment and really just, it's the softer side to life. You know, if the warrior is all about going out and battling for what they want, then the lover is all about appreciating what they have. So, I was never really the lover type growing up. I didn't really appreciate much of what I had. And as far as I was concerned, as soon as I hit this goal, well, that wasn't good enough. I got to hit this one. And then I hit that one and that wasn't good enough. And it was just this cycle, which ended up completely dulling my sword. This is apparently my sword. It's a pen. And that leads to, when you have an unbalanced life, when you become a king or you become a queen in your own life, which is basically you rule over all that you've built, the problem is that you become a tyrant, or you become just, it's almost like a childish version of an adult. And this world is filled with childish versions of adults, of people who look mature, but there is no growth that has really taken place in their lives spiritually or mentally. They've simply grown up physically. They're boys, they're girls, they're children in adult bodies because they haven't cultivated themselves. Now, when you become a king or a queen in that area and you become a tyrant because you're unbalanced and you want what you want and you're too far into the warrior mentality side of things, you're going to destroy everything you've built. Or if you don't destroy it, you're going to continue to go full steam ahead to the point of where you have, I mean, the word is balance. You have no balance in your life, and you'll end up pretty much destroying yourself. Now, the reason that I had told her that she needs to kind of relax a little bit and find a balance in her life somehow is because when she gets out of work, she's crashing utterly and completely. She's got this goal that she's holding herself to, and high goals are great, but she brought up that she's like, well, how do people become successful? You talk about all these types of people and da-da-da-da. Yes, I do. But we are not equal at all. And don't ever make the mistake of thinking that we are created equal. We are not. Are we equally as important? Sure. But Michael Jordan is 6'12", okay? I don't know how tall he is, but Michael Jordan's a pretty tall fella. I'm 5'10". We're not created equal. Michael Jordan has opportunities that I will never have. And I have opportunities Michael Jordan will never have. But there's something also that we forget is that we have to create our own opportunities as well. Just a little nugget of knowledge. But in the end, Michael Jordan is going to be far better at basketball than I am. I'm going to have to run twice as fast on a physical standpoint because his legs are twice as long as mine. We're not created equal. So can I measure up against him in basketball if I were to spend my life trying to do so? Yeah, maybe I could. But there are some other areas and certain other passions of which I would rather enjoy. You know, when it comes down to like motorcycles and it comes down to, you know, some of the stunts that I do, maybe I'm far better than he would be at it. Because with his tall body, it might be hard for him to get around the bike or get around the quads or, you know, find a quad that even fits him, right? So what I'm trying to say is that, yes, there are some people in the world who can operate on 2 to 3 hours of sleep a night. Some of them even less. I personally know a woman who is, I think she's 42 or 43. She has 6 children. She is a single mother. She has her own house. She has built a drag racing car. I hope this bug doesn't crawl back onto the lens. There he goes. He's on the lens. Goodbye. Goodbye. Go away. She has a built drag racing car that she works on herself. She owns 2 businesses. Let's see. She used to be a Patriots cheerleader. I mean, this woman sleeps maybe, I don't know, an hour, 2 hours a night or something like that. If that, it's absolutely incredible for her to be able to function. I am not built that way. I need 8 to 10 hours a night, period. If I don't get that, I am off center and off balance in everything that I do. I know this video is getting long, but I'm trying to get these points across to you. The most important thing that you can do is to know thyself, all right? You need to know what you're good at and what you're not. And then focus on what it is that you want to cultivate in your life. You can cultivate your weaknesses. You can take your weaknesses and turn them into strengths. But you also have to know what works and what doesn't for you. Some of the advice that I give on this channel, it's not going to work for you. It's just not. And in fact, what you have to do is you have to take what I say sometimes with a grain of salt. And other things that I say, you're going to have to go, you know what? That's really good. I'm going to take that nugget of knowledge. I'm going to store it away in my computer. And I'm going to pull it up from time to time when I need to utilize it. But to take everything that I say as word and law, it's not going to get you anywhere. In the end of the day, your life is your own. And you're the one living it. So when you read a book, the best way to know what to follow is what resonates with you. And what I mean by that is that a lot of people think in their minds. You have to think in life with your heart. It has to be a balance. Again, balance, okay? When you think in your heart, when you've got a speaker speaking to you, or you've got a friend in your life saying something, or a parent, or anybody saying anything to you, and you feel them, or a song comes on and it gives you those chills that you feel when a certain lyric is said and it touches you and you feel it throughout your body, listen to that. Because when you have that experience, that resonance within yourself, that is the stuff that you need to hold on to. Those are the nuggets of knowledge that make you go, oh, you know what? That's what I need. So anyways, I want to make this video for you guys because you need to have balance in your life. You can't listen to everything I'm saying. I mean, it's even if you look at the way that East and West, okay? Eastern philosophy, Western philosophy, you know, what do we really cultivate in both of the cultures, right? You've got, in the West, you have a lot of left-brained, logical thinking, you know, types of people who are all about work, 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 build this life, get money, build this, do that, and it's a very left-brained way of looking at the world, and it's cut and dry, and it works. A lot of things get done, you know, despite how, you know, there's a lot of lazy people and stuff. Look, truth of the matter is, in America, or in Western, you know, ideals and thoughts about the world, a lot of stuff gets done. A lot of inventions get created. When you go over to, like, Western philosophy, when you go over to Eastern philosophy, and, you know, you go over to the likes of, like, the teachings of, say, Osho or, you know, Buddha or all these other teachers over there, what you get is this really spiritualistic approach to life. You get this, you want to be centered, you want to be one with nature, you want to, you know, you get a lot of the monks, a lot of the deep spiritualistic teachers. Well, here's the thing. If you're 100% spiritual, you're really not getting anything done in the physical world. If you're all about the physical world, you have no balance and you're going to be miserable. You have to take bits and pieces. It's the yin yang. Is yin better than yang? Is night better than day? I mean, which is better? If you like night and I like day, which one of us is right? Right? You have to decide for yourself to mix and match everything that comes into your life and create this perfect balance within oneself. And you have to know yourself while doing so. So for her path, maybe it's served her up till this point to work the way that she is, but one of the biggest lies that we ever take into ourselves is that hard work is going to get us the results that we want. Hard work is not going to get the results that you want. I have seen countless people throughout my years who just work hard and they don't work smart. And what I mean by that is that you can have iron workers and policemen and, you know, contractors. I mean, contractors are some of the hardest working busting their ass type people out there, along with mechanics, along with all the manual labor is probably some of the hardest work out there, right? And I'm not downplaying anybody else, but you have to get up, you have to break your body down day after day, you have to bust your ass, and oftentimes you're not making that much money, you're exhausted, and you get home, you just want to crash, and you're busting your ass working hard. But how many of us know some people who are in that industry who have no money? They're doing the hardest work out there and they have no money. Hard work does not bring you all this money. Smart work brings you all this money. And it's a balance between working with discipline, you know, hard, we could say, working with discipline and working with intelligence. And what are you doing with your money? Are you investing your money? You don't make money by spending money or by saving money. Neither way makes money. Investing your money makes money. So what are you investing in? I mean, I'm on one of my Josh rants now, but it's just, you want to have a balance in life, because if you're not balanced in any area of your life, whether it's the lover, the warrior, the magician, or the king, the king is the ruler, you're not going to be balanced in the rest of the areas of the life. And the problem is that this is where your body, your physiology, your mind-body connection will actually disintegrate, and it will turn into sickness. You know, this is where you get the ulcers, the hernias, the mental deep migraines, the lowered immune system. The higher the stress in your life, the lower your immune system is, the more susceptible you are to all this other crap. The thing is, guys, your body does have breaking points. You got to think of your body as if it's a car, as if it's a vessel or a vehicle that you're going through this life with, right? If you take a car and you run it nonstop without stopping, first off, you're going to run out of gas, plain and simple. Second, you're going to have wear and tear on that car if you're not properly maintaining it, if you don't clean up underneath after, you know, they put that crap on the roads during the winter, you're going to start to have rot. Okay, what could you metaphorically look at that as? You know, all the crap that we accumulate throughout life, if you don't deal with it, if you don't deal with your feelings, if you don't deal with, you know, certain emotional baggage you may have had, or you let your problems pile up in life, I mean, all that kind of stuff is going to hold you down. What happens with the mind-body connection is that you end up, your body will stop you after a certain point. You have warning signs, which are basically like code yellow alerts, which, you know, you could look at those as headaches or stomach aches, or you have diarrhea or all that kinds of stuff. But if you let those warning signs go unnoticed or if you don't act upon those warning signs, your body will stop you. Make no mistake. Look up some of the greatest, most successful people throughout of history. Their breakdowns are incredible. Look up Walt Disney. Walt Disney, one of the most successful men who's ever lived, built this ridiculously huge empire that still stands today. Look up his breakdowns. All right? I'm not saying that you don't push yourself to build the life that you want, but I'm saying if you do it without balance and you're pushing yourself too hard, the gears in your car are going to break down. Your oil needs to be changed. Your valves are going to go bad. I mean, without proper maintenance of your body, your vessel, and without listening to the warning alarms that go off, you're going to crash. And then when you crash, you end up having what's known as a mental breakdown or a nervous breakdown. Well, the problem with nervous breakdowns, in fact, one of my clients has them quite badly. She will all of a sudden start crying for no reason. She has no idea why. She just starts crying throughout the day. These are nervous breakdowns, at least the kind that she's having. And she doesn't act upon them. Well, they're becoming more frequent, or they were becoming more frequent. Eventually, you can have a serious mental breakdown. I'm talking months, possibly years of your life, depending on how hard you have pushed yourself and how little you have taken care of yourself with improper nutrition, with numbing yourself, whether it's with alcohol or drugs or whatever it is that forces that calm over your body, because what you're doing is forcing it. You don't want to force it. You want to go through life like it's a stream. You want to enjoy the ride. You want to go around the rocks. You don't want to slam into every rock that comes your way and just blow it apart, because you're going to blow your body apart. And the problem is, when you have one of those serious breakdowns, which I speak from personal experience, I have had two of those in my life. I'm only 28 years old, and I've had two major breakdowns where I'm talking functionality went out the window. I couldn't even answer the phone. The phone would ring, I would look at it, and I'd get freaked out and just lose my shit. It's pretty bad, and it sounds funny, but it's really not funny when it's going on. And you can't get away from it. Your body will force you and grind you to a halt, and you will lose everything that you've built, because you cannot function. Like, you can't get out of bed, you can't walk. Think about like the absolute sickest you've ever been in your life. It's worse than that in terms of what you're actually able to accomplish. You'll get nothing done. So try to figure out what's right for you, but take the time to have that balance in life. Don't just watch this channel and think that every day I am completely balls to the wall, working, busting my ass every single day. Do I work every day? Yes, I do. I don't take any days off. Doesn't matter if it's Sunday, doesn't matter if it's nighttime, whatever. I am working every single day, but I also have a balance every single day. So if you stayed to this point of the video, I'm kind of surprised. I hope you enjoyed the bug climbing on the camera. I know I get into my rants sometimes and stuff, but it's just there's a lot to say, and you can't really just pigeonhole it into saying like have a balance, because people don't really know how to have that balance. I mean, what is fun to you? What is it that you really, really enjoy doing that you haven't done in a really long time? I mean, how many days per week do you hang out with somebody who you truly love? You know, I mean, we love our grandparents, we love our parents, we love our friends. A lot of times we just see our friends, you know? Guys, grandma's gonna die one day, you know? Spend some time with her. So, anyways, appreciate you guys watching this. If you like the content, subscribe, and shoot any questions you got my way. I'd love to answer them for you. I'll talk to you.